are back here with part two of the year-end closer show here. As we get these matches from these indie shows, as Kelly Adams makes her way down to the ring, Eva Lise is already in the ring. The winner of this match will be added to the women's title match at Showdown in San Francisco. Will Kelly Adams be added? Will she get her opportunity here to get back in the women's title match here and be able to knock off Eva Lise, who is a former multi-time champion, the most decorated women's champion in UWA history? Eva Lise, of course, would love nothing more than to get back in that title picture, as she lost the title to Andy Jaden back at Showdown in Sioux City earlier in the year, around February. January, actually, rather, I should say. And here we go. The bell is rung here at this indie show here tonight. The crowd loving it. Kelly Adams starting out strong with a slap across the face right into a half and half suplex. Just drove Eva Lise on her damn neck, and now Kelly just driving Evie's head into the canvas here. Eva Lise kicking out at literally nothing. And we've got a few contests for you tonight. We've got this, and of course, the main purpose of this show, part two, the Beat the Clock Challenge, to decide who will face Hammerstone at Showdown. Hammerstone will be putting his title on the line in triple threat action. We'll have multiple Beat the Clock matches later tonight to decide not only who will get to face him, but also who will get the stipulation, the man with the shortest time tonight, whether it's the champion or one of the two challengers. We'll get to start the match with a weapon of their choosing. And Eva Lise connects with a nice drop kick on Kelly Adams. So essentially it will be a normal triple threat match, minus the fact that whoever has the shortest time of the night that qualifies for the match will get a weapon of their choice to start the match. Right when the bell rings, they will have a weapon in hand. The other two will not. They will be able to use that to their advantage. Exploder suplex. Right there from Eva Lise to Kelly Adams. It's going to be a huge opportunity for whoever can get the shortest time tonight and beat the clock. Of course, I believe we will go over to Hammerstone next, who is in a separate venue as the champion. He is issuing out an open challenge for his match in the Beat the Clock series. Kelly Adams right back up to her feet here, and Kelly drops Eva Lise with an axe handle. What a wicked axe handle that was from Kelly Adams. Kelly sends her into the corner. Nice combination of kicks there from the Glampire. Kelly was just laying down kicks on Eva Lise there. Now she set her up on the ropes here. And no. And a bit of an ass action there from Kelly Adams as she dropped down hip first on Eva Lise's back. Now Evie pulling herself up to the ropes here as Kelly Adams in control. Eva Lise counters, drops out to the floor. And yet again, Eva Lise gloating in the ring. The expense of Kelly Adams. Kelly right back in. Eva Lise sends her into the corner. Evie full speed ahead, chop across the chest. Vintage Eva Lise here off the ropes. Drop kick goes out of the head. The crowd here tonight, this BCW show is loving this. Eva Lise drops an elbow, the knee of Kelly Adams. Evie now gonna snap her down, and a corkscrew roundhouse kick from Eva Lise. Drilled Kelly Adams here. I think our camera crew here for coming to the show tonight, but nonetheless, only a one count for Eva Lise. Crowd's gonna love it here. They're getting superstars on this show. Eva Lise is calling up Kelly Adams. She's going in for the kill here. If that Desert Eagle connects, it's over, and there we go. One, two, and three. Eva Lise knocks off Kelly Adams. And what, wait, what the hell? Oh, that's Almeida. Jessica Almeida is here. What the hell? And, oh, kick right to the face of Eva Lise. What the hell is Almeida doing here? And it appears, yes, she's busted Eva Lise open. What the hell? Jessica Almeida showing up out of nowhere right there and just busting the lease open. And whereas now the Northern Television Champion Hammerstone. The hell is this today?
From Glendale, Arizona, weighing in at 245 pounds, the Universal Wrestling Alliance Northern World Television Champion.
Thank you, man. But nonetheless, Hammerstone
champion.
I showed up in this parking lot show here. I guarantee this crowd was not expecting a champion the caliber of Hammerstone to show up in this damn parking lot. The hell are these guys waiting for? Where the hell are we at? The airport? Well, I believe we're up the freaking, never mind. I wasn't going to go there. Nonetheless, who the hell will be facing Hammerstone right here tonight in this damn parking lot in this beat the clock challenge? Hammerstone issuing an open challenge here. And literally anyone on the roster could have accepted, but it is being accepted by the Elite's Hangman, Adam Page. The Hangman will be accepting the challenge here tonight. What an opportunity this is for Hangman Page. Fighting out of Chesapeake, Virginia. Red Dead World is going to be right up the valley here. This parking lot brawl for the Hangman. Adam Page, a good Hangman, does have a victory over the five-star savior, Adam Page. We've got to keep that in mind, although this is only Hangman's third match ever in UWA. Hangman debuted earlier this year when he took on Adam Page. Of course, he beat the five-star savior with the help of Marty Skrull that time. Marty, of course, is not here tonight as he is going to be competing and beat the clock as well. You know, Hangman would love nothing more than to wear out Hammerstone here. Maybe help out Marty or Kenny Omega later. Hangman right away running to Hammerstone full speed, just dropped him with a clothesline. And this parking lot area is too poor to even put up a clock here to beat the clock, so we're going to have to try to keep an eye on the timer. But Hangman with a freaking eye rake to Hammerstone, the champ right now, then trouble back suplex from the Hangman. Hangman in full control so far, but now Hammerstone's lighting up. Hangman drops him with a shoulder tackle. And a nice star press. This is going to be a knockdown drag out here between the Hangman and the champion Hammerstone. As Hangman now lifts him up to his feet, Hammerstone counterweights Hangman into the corner. Shot to the midsection, another shot to the ribs. And now Hangman's in trouble here. Exploder suplex into the buckles. Now Hammerstone is retaking control here. One into the buckles and now one into the canvas. Hammerstone now is retaking control here as the champ. Now he's got him up. TKO. Beautiful maneuver there from Hammerstone, but Hangman counters. Hangman fighting right back into it, but Hammerstone counterwhips him into the corner. Hammerstone back in control. Hangman counters again. Now Hangman looking golden moonsault, and it connects. What a move from Hangman Page. Hammerstone counters that Spineman Carry takeover from the champ. Hammer's looking to follow up. Hangman blocks. Hangman Page trying to wear down Hammerstone. And I wonder, does he want to finish the match quicker, add damage to Hammerstone going for the kill? Or does he want to wear it out and make sure Hammerstone is the one getting that weapon? Starting the match, Hammerstone, of course, is guaranteed to be in the match, unlike the other people tonight and beat the clock. And of course, he is the champion. Hammerstone hits him with a nice suplex in the ground position. Now Hammerstone showing off his muscles here. You know damn well Hammerstone's just trying to finish off Hangman quick. Thinking get that weapon to start off the match, and Hangman with a nice counter. God, he definitely doesn't want to lose though. But he for sure won't be getting the weapon. Now Hangman setting up here. Buckshot. Lariat connects. Dialed up the buckshot there in Hangman cover. One, two up the buckshot Lariat, and only a two count. Hangman's got to stay focused here. That's what put away Adam Page. He's got to come up with a new plan here, and he's going to go right of passage. But Hammerstone's too strong. He blocks it. Now Hammerstone is bouncing Hangman's face off the buckle there. A love lost here from the champ, Hammerstone. Hammerstone stomps away on the Hangman. Hammerstone back in control here, but Hangman caught the leg into a dragon screw. Hammerstone caught him with a left hook there. Now Hammer's got the Hangman up and hangs him out to dry on the ropes. Gotta be up to around 4 minutes now at this point. Only a one count there for Hammerstone. Hangman counters. Hangman Page going Death Valley Driver here, but no, Hammerstone. Hammerstone blocks. Now Hammerstone, overhead belly to belly. Hammerstone pushes right up off the mat there, showcasing his strength. Here is Hammerstone with a deadlift powerbomb. Holy crap, Hammerstone right now is tooling Hangman. Cover, one, two count. Kick to the back. Hangman right back up to his feet, kick to the stomach, thumbs up, thumbs down, pile driver. Hangman trying to continue to rally up the time here. A late sweep there from Hammerstone. Now Hammerstone gonna look to put him away here. Hammer gonna look to put away the Hangman. He's got him up, Nightmare, pendulum, and for the cover, 26, 27, 28. The time to beat here tonight is 4 minutes, 28 seconds, set by Hammerstone. So the rest of the competitors here tonight, if they want to start out with a weapon instead of a champ, they're gonna have to beat 428. A nice time limit set there by Hammerstone. Impressive victory for the champ here over Hangman Page. But we're going to take a short break and come back to that, as Delson Hollow has promised he is going to put on a display here tonight for Aleister Black and The Undertaker. Hollow claims within the preview of what is going to be to Aleister Black at Showdown in San Francisco. Delson Hollow, the Outlaw, of course, the survivor of Ring Warriors of 2019. Delson Hollow is acknowledged as a Ring Warrior now for the remainder of 2019 and the start of 2020. The Ring Warrior, Delson Hollow, the Ghost Rider of the UWA, is looking to make a statement here tonight. He says he's got a surprise for Aleister Black and The Undertaker. Of course, and then like that, we'll get back to the Beat the Clock matches. We're just getting started with that. He's back. It's the Overlord, Marcus Holloway.
What the fuck?
Fuck, this guy is gone. He is from UWA, but I guess now we know where Marcus has been. What the hell shitty in new show this is. Marcus get paid on the Indies? can't imagine any idiot saying, I mean, he does got that. He does have a name behind him now, I guess. Obvious shots here at the Undertaker and Aleister Black. Make it so easy to give Cena the big boot. Choke slam the last ride. Are you excited yet? 24/7 WrestleMania paychecks. Yeah, 2-3-2 is my record. That feels like a weird way to say that. I don't even know what to say right now. Marcus Holloway is the surprise treat for the Undertaker and Aleister Black. Mocking the Undertaker as Delson Hall getting in the head of Undertaker's favorite weapon, Aleister Black. As Delson Hall, now Hall locking the Sleepy Hollow already on Marcus Holloway, just toying with him. There's Hall, he's looking to put him away right away, but Marcus Holloway fought out of it. Marcus fought out of it there. Kind of surprising. Now Hall has done him up. Marcus Holloway might be the biggest jobber in UWA history. A little jawbreaker counter here from Marcus. Marcus is trying to get something going here, but Hall counters out. God sends him shoulder first, right into the ring post. Marcus is trying to fight back, man, but look at him. He's a freaking string bean. Hall's not in the best shape, and Hall's already busted open. Like I say, he's not in the best shape. He just had to survive Ring Warriors. I mean, this is freaking Marcus of all people. Hall just decked him. Elbow from Marcus. Those freaking pointy, freaking bony elbows from Marcus busting Hall open. I think that might be the first time ever that Hall has gotten busted open without actually getting hit with a move yet. I just want to point that out. That's kind of funny. But nonetheless, Hall right now is just toying with Marcus at this point. So Marcus hasn't even really hit a move yet. Hall is just fucking him up. God, now the Sleepy Hollow is locked back in on Marcus. And, Marcus, and yeah, night-night, Marcus. I almost wish to say that was the shortest match in UWA history, but I don't know. I think that might have been longer than Bronwyn Bryson Blade got squashed by Xander Mercer back on NXT was about 2015, 2016. Might have been a little bit longer, but I think that's the least amount of moves anyone's ever gotten the match, possibly. Nonetheless, Paulo sends a message to Aleister Black and The Undertaker as we get back to beat the clock. Here's Hammerstone set the time of 4:28. But not only do these guys got to try to beat that time if they want to start the match with a weapon, but they're going to have to win the match if they want to get in the title match. There's three matches. Only two of them are going to move on to showdown. The two people with the shortest time move on to showdown.
E.Y. Drake.
Dummy.
Yeah.
The following contest is E.Y.
Drake. Yeah. He even showed her, and she's still boxing. No, dummy, it's Eli Drake. Yeah. Nonetheless, Eli Drake. And if he would move on to showdown, he's not even contracted to UWA right now. If he were to move on to showdown, we would have to give him a contract, because you can't compete for a title unless you're contracted in UWA. So this is a huge opportunity for Eli Drake. It's like low-key, it's like there's a title. But there's a contract, rather, guaranteed in this title match as well for Eli Drake. Dummy, yeah, Eli Drake, yeah. Eli Drake, of course, competed earlier this year in the trio with Hammerstone, of all people, the champion, and, of course, Brian Cage. And Eli Drake's opponent here tonight, the troublemaker, EC3. Ethan Carter III, of course, last year at the final WrestleVerse in UWA history, went one-on-one with the sadistic son of a bitch, your UWA Hall of Famer Randy Orton. First we get a head punch off by Orton. Well, no, that was Braun that got head punch off by Orton. Still, speaking of Braun, we've got to get freaking, we'll talk about that. A later date, but nonetheless, hopefully we can get a beat the clock here. We got an extra venue this time. Can't believe out of all the matches, we have the one champion that's featured in these matches here at this indie show. The champion went to the indie show in the parking lot. That's tremendous. But nonetheless, EC3, Eli Drake about to go head-to-head this crowd. Here we got the work cut out for me tonight, the main event of this indie show. I don't even know where the hell they're at right now. I could care less even though. And nonetheless, EC3, Eli Drake, this is a star-studded freaking main event here. UWA's EC3 made it to the arena. Of course, like I said, Eli Drake has been on UWA program in a little while, but he can get himself back on to do with Winnie tonight. EC3, you know, wants to be on Showdown, though. A letdown would be for him in his career if he went from fighting Randy Orton at the last WrestleVerse tonight and being a Showdown in San Francisco. I didn't think it was that Showdown in Sin City. Just both Showdowns, that'd be freaking horrendous. And ring the bell, and okay, we do have a clock up there, so we're good. Eli Drake threw the first punch. EC3 caught him. A variation of the 1% of there. Come on, ref. EC3's going for the win in the first 10 seconds, and Eli Drake kicks out of the one. You know Eli's stunned, though. EC3 caught him off guard there. Eli Drake might be in trouble already within the first 10 seconds of the match. Eli Drake shook right now. EC3 going right at him. Eli Drake with a nice counter right into a clothesline. Dummy, yeah. Eli's going to build some offense here, though. EC3's got him rocking in. And TK3. EC3 is rocking and rolling right now. Oh God, 1%er! EC3 hit all his big moves there within the first minute of the match. EC3 just telling Eli Drake to bring it right now. EC3, you know damn well, he thinks he's in full control of this right now, and he very well may be. We're only a minute in here. EC3 is already destroying Eli Drake. But right there, Eli counters with a clothesline. He needs to build some offense here, but EC3 keeps countering him. Corkscrew neck breaker. Beautiful move there from EC3. He's going for the kill here. He's going for another TK3. It's all over. If he hits this, Eli Drake counters. And now Eli transitions, release Tiger Bomb. Now it's Eli Drake and needs to build some offense here, build some momentum. And he is looking to do just that. Dummy, yeah. We're looking for some blunt force trauma. The BFT connects right into the cover from Eli Drake. Only a two count for the Namer of Dummies. No one's got a UWA contract just like that. And Skylord Slam from Eli Drake. EC3 now in control of Eli Drake. Eli Drake, let's go of him in front face lock into the snapmare. EC3 in control. They have about 2 minutes left here to capitalize to get the pin before Hammerstone did. Get that weapon and start the match. And Eli Drake's going for the gravy train. And gravy train connects to EC3. Could Eli Drake do it? Can he start the match with the weapon? And no, EC3 kicks out of two. Eli Drake not only is trying to beat Hammerstone's time, but then he's going to make a short enough time where it guarantees him the match still. So we have two other beat the clock matches still to come. EC3 counters with a jawbreaker. And EC3 sends him into the corner. EC3 splash. Now he's going to go for another. Couple EC3 splashes back to back to Eli Drake. Eli's in trouble. Now Eli with a Northern Larry at DC3. Set him up as he goes for that second gravy train, drop him on his head. Eli's got a minute left. DC3 counters. DC3 might want to go in for a cover off that clothesline. Got less than a minute left here. Try to break Hammerstone's record and start the match with a weapon. EC3 needs to throw him back in the ring, and I think he just realized that. He needs to quit wasting time. Come on, EC3, get in the ring, man. Got less than 30 seconds at this point. And he went to stomp and moved out of the way. EC3 now firing back in with some clotheslines here. Oh, man, they got 20 seconds left here. EC3's talking more shit. Come on, man. EC3 splashing like Drake moves out of the way. And Eli's got him up. Gravy Train connects. The one-way ticket. 2 and 3. Eli Drake just beat Hammerstone's time limit. Clock stopped at 4:24. Eli Drake just beat Hammerstone's time by 4 seconds. Would almost say that guarantees Eli Drake a contract here in the UWA for 2020.
The following contest.
We move on to this other venue, Ricochet.
Making his way to
and
the
going
ring.
One-on-one with Rey Mysterio. And to beat the clock. And if anyone can beat that time limit made by Eli Drake, it's got to be Ricochet or Rey Mysterio. The Luchadors, that's gonna give them an advantage. They're used to wrestling at a fast pace. They're gonna have to beat 4:24 though. It's gonna be easier said than done. Eli Drake beating EC3 at 4:24. So right now at this rate, Eli Drake's got the weapon to start the match, and he's got a contract for 2020 as well. He has competed for that Northern Television title against his former trio partner, Hammerstone. And we're away Ricochet's opponent here, Rey Mysterio. 1/3 of the Lucha Click is the Lucha Libre legend, the King, Rey Mysterio. Rey Mysterio would love nothing more than to represent the Lucha Click. I showed him in San Francisco in a title match. Of course, we know Pentagon Jr. Leather hands forward an IC title match with the one KSJ. A showdown as well. The Lucha Click would love nothing more than for two of their three members have title matches, a showdown. And Mysterio's gonna have to be 4:24 though. And Ricochet starting out strong right at him with a catch runner there. Ricochet not gonna waste time. Going in for the kill early here. We see EC3 go for a quick cover in their match. And Rey Mysterio now is gonna go for one of his own here. Crucifix, only a one count. And Mysterio has the right idea here. We're less than 30 seconds into this match here. Of course, the final qualifier to end the night is going to be the Elite, Marty Scurll, versus the other Elite member, Kenny Omega, in a brotherly battle. See what time they're going to have to beat at this point. Kick to the back there from Ricochet. And now he catches him with the standing Spanish fly. Ricochet or Rey Mysterio were to end this match in, say, 2 minutes or something. Then Marty or Kenny Omega have to win their match inside 4:24. I mean, you can't go inside Hammerstone's time. I mean, he's already a champion. It doesn't really count towards that aspect of it. It has to be a triple threat match. Now Rey Mysterio set him up, he's gonna dial up 619. And the 619 connects to Ricochet. Mysterio to the top, He's looking to end it inside 2 minutes here and dropping a dime, but Ricochet counters with the knees. And Ricochet counter whips Mysterio into the corner. And now, oh God, Ricochet's going to look to match Mysterio around the ring post, 619. Now Ricochet at the top. Now he's going to look to drop a dime in. That is the double rotation moonsault. And it connects, cover one. Only a one count. We're 2 minutes in, Ricochet only got a one count off of Rey Mysterio. Tells you he's going to have to dish out a lot more damage. Nice DDT with a kick up Ricochet. Wasting no time, leaping to the top rope here. And 630 connects. That's gotta be it. Ricochet is moving on inside 2.5 minutes, but Mysterio kicks out. Mysterio will not lie down for Ricochet here. Ricochet may just force him in. He's keeping the pace. Ricochet with a tope in the forearm to Rey Mysterio. And Ricochet truly is the king of flight right now, man. He's not letting up. Ricochet just move after move after move. He is not slowing down. And Eli Drake is in trouble right now. Ricochet caught him with a clothesline. Kips right back up to his feet. Standing star press. Cover from Ricochet. One, two, no. Mysterio still able to kick out at two. Ricochet is just hitting him with a bunch of shit right now. Mysterio finally able to counter. Rey, sunset flip, cover from Mysterio. Mysterio can steal it, but no, Ricochet counters into a pinball attempt. Ricochet, no. Holy crap, if I'm Eli Drake right now, I'm sweating. And Mysterio, 619. 619 connects again from Mysterio. Now Mysterio. No, he went Eddie Guerrero there, but Ricochet yet again got the knees up. And if Mysterio could drop that final freaking diving move on to Ricochet, he'd win the damn match. Mysterio gets countered there by Ricochet. Ricochet, Northern Lights, bridge through. The strength of Ricochet, he needs to go in for a cover off of that. And now Mysterio counters. And he used that to pin Rollins. And now it is impossible for him to start the match with the weapon. Dragon Rana from Ricochet. They still want to finish it in a short time though. Make it difficult for Marty or Kenny to get into the match. Now Ricochet the top. Rey Mysterio rolling out to the floor. That can cost them both. Ricochet is drilled. Mysterio with a diving elbow to the back of the neck, and he's not finished there. Oh God, no, right into the ring post and now into the floor on the outside. And Mysterio's gotta be hurt. He just drove him back first into the goddamn steel. Spine first rather, now head first into the ring post goes Mysterio. Mysterio just took him off his feet there. Now Rey gonna send Ricochet back into the ring, but Ricochet counters. I wonder what type of condition Rey Mysterio is in right now. Ricochet setting him up, going for that European uppercut, but Rey Mysterio dodges it. We're up to 5.5 minutes now. They need to try to end this quickly here. Time's starting to get up there, man. Ricochet gets counter-whipped in the corner by Mysterio. Rey. Oh God, Rey taking a page out of the playbook of Ricochet here around the ring post goes Rey Mysterio. 619. And now Rey immediately to the top rope here. Waiting for Ricochet to get up to his feet. Dragon Rana plants him on his neck. Mysterio with the upset at this point, and no, Ricochet kicks out of two somehow. He about ended it on a 619 there. Literally, Ricochet caught the Dragon Rana that time into a powerbomb. Holy crap, I did not expect this match to go this long. I figured this would be by far be the shortest match. So Fights got the drop kick, fist right to the face. He's caught him again. Northern Lights, bridge through Ricochet with the strength. And wait a minute, Mysterio lands on his feet. Ray drop kicks him into the back and Ricochet into the ropes. He's dialing up 619. Now Mysterio to the top. Looking to drop the area code again, but yet again Ricochet gets the knees up. And we're up to 7 minutes right now. This is starting to get really easy for Skrull and Omega. Now try to put this away quick. They definitely do not want to get over that 10-minute mark. Ricochet sidesteps, Rey Mysterio sends him back into the corner. Ricochet counters, leg sweep. Single leg Boston Crab locked in here by Ricochet. Trying desperately to get Mysterio to tap out. And Rey shoves him off. Mysterio groaning here, he's wasting time. And he gave time for Ricochet to recuperate. Ricochet moved out of the way. Mysterio sends Ricochet right into the corner there. Ricochet counters. And Ricochet set him up. Now Ricochet's gonna go for it. And he's looking to dial it up around the ring. Close 619. Bust Mysterio open. Mysterio can't take much more neck, upper back damage there. And now Ricochet knows that he's not wasting time. Follows up Northern Lights. Bridge through, he got him up the strength. Brain Buster right on the neck. Cover from Ricochet. 1, 2. And finally Ricochet clocking out at 8:30. Jesus Christ, man, that went longer than I expected, so we're getting right to the final match here, but Ricochet clocked out at 8:30 there. You might want to check on Mysterio, because he took some brutal bumps there. And left Kenny Omega went his way out of the ring here. Big grief, he's back home here in Japan as Kenny Omega.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall, making his way to the ring from Winnipeg, Manitoba, Canada, weighing in at 229 pounds, Kenny Omega.
So now we know if Omega or Skrull want to be in that title match or showdown, they will have to win this inside 8 minutes and 30 seconds. So we will put a reverse clock up. It will count down from 8 minutes and 30 seconds. They will have to win the match before that timer is up. They want to get in the title match. Ricochet and Mysterio taking way too much time, giving Omega and Skrull a decent chance here. Of course, the same thing applies for these two. If they want to get the weapon to start out the match, they're going to have to win this inside 4 minutes and, what was it, 24 seconds? Yeah, 424. They're going to have to get inside 424. They want to start with the weapon right now. Eli Drake is getting the weapon to start the match. What a season of an opportunity there from Eli Drake. Only does he have a contract now in UWA. Guaranteed since Ricochet and Mysterio took longer than him. And not only is he in a title match, but he gets the weapon to start the match. Unless the villain Marty Skrull or Kenny Omega has anything to say about it. You know damn well if Marty gets the weapon to start the match, he's going to pick a damn umbrella. Marty Skrull, probably the man in this Beat the Clock, the challenge that's had the best record all year. The villain holding that Universe title case all the way up until Dead End. Then he loses the case to Adam Page. And of course, Adam Page lost the case in Ring Warriors. Dawson Hollow will now be challenging Aleister Black. for the Universe Championship at Showdown in San Francisco. What a matchup that is going to be. The first time ever matchup between Hollow and Aleister Black. Wells, right now we've got a first time ever matchup here in Japan for this show, as they're getting a treaty to close their show in Japan. I don't know what fucking time it is over there right now. They do this freaking match in the morning. Nonetheless, the clock is up, and we've got this clock started here. They've got 8 minutes, 30 seconds. Of course, it's counting down. Interesting decision here between these two to start the match off slowly with some chain wrestling. Omega is in control on Skrull, and he takes Skrull off his feet. These elite brethren right now are looking to have a war here. Marty Skrull is not about to let Omega take it down that quickly. One of these two is going to hit the move first. Marty backflipping out of that German suplex, avoiding disaster. And the arm, there's Omega. Omega hip toss. Cartwheel into the V-trigger. So now flipping out of that one. And Omega hits the first move here. Marty Skrull back into the ring. DDT. So far, one for one. They're even right now. Oh, God, and a V-trigger out of nowhere from Omega. A minion is now up in this contest. Omega connecting with another V-trigger there. Now the second V-trigger of the match, and we see him do this to Fatal at Showdown Sin City. A ring trigger, a flurry of V-triggers from Kenny Omega. Not even a one count. Marty moves out of the way and takes out the knee. That's genius from Skrull there. He can't do many V-triggers if his knee's busted up. Marty yet again back after the V-trigger. Right back after that bicycle knee, that V-trigger of Kenny Omega. Omega going to look to change things up there with a tornado DDT. Now Skrull going to attempt to lock in a submission hold here. Or Kenny Omega, rather. Trying to tap out Marty Skrull. You know damn well the villain's not going to submit that easily. They've got 6:30 to go here. Another 2 minutes have transpired here within this contest. Nice V-trigger again from Omega. Gotta be careful though, he can't pull out too many of those, will hurt his knee. Since Skrull's been targeted, but now Omega's looking in things early. Won't matter if he can end it here. He's called for that one-winged angel. Is it all over? Marty Skrull counters into a hurricanrana. Marty had the antidote to the one-winged angel, and now cross-face chicken wing. Omega tried to finish early, now it's Skrull. Skrull's got him in the chicken wing. If Skrull makes a tap here, he's walking out with the freaking weapon to start the match here. And no, Omega does not tap, but he might be out. Skrull's going into the cover, only a one count. And now we are 3 minutes into the contest here. They've got about a minute and a half here. They want to start the match with a weapon. Marty Skrull from the top going for an elbow drop. Misses. Bad idea. Corico Crusher from Kenny Omega. Omega just rolls him over. Omega wants to start the match with that weapon. That's for sure. He's going for covers here. Kenny Omega looking for a drop. Kick to the back. Marty Skrull sidesteps. Knee to the face. Knee to the face from the villain. No, Eli Drake is guaranteed as one of the challenges for Hammerstone, that title. And Dr. Bomb from Omega. Omega's got roughly a minute left here. And he's still kicked to the stomach, doubles him over. And the villain now. Oh God, Tombstone, pile driver. From the villain, and Skrull backing up. This is his last chance if he wants to get that weapon. Is there Eli Drake, and Omega blocks me in the stomach. And Dragon Rush, Omega needs to go in for a cover there. And that was literally their last chance at starting the match with a weapon there. We know for sure now it's going to be Eli Drake who gets the weapon, but Kenny Omega's pissed. He just chucked Skrull out to the freaking floor. Marty just bounced back first off the floor on the outside here. Kenny Omega. And so we see him do that as well. The Fatalist Showdown. Omega pulling out all the stops here. Marty Scurll able to dodge that crossbody. And now Omega's got to be just as hurt as Scurll. So now the only factor here, the only thing you got to watch out for is they've got to win this match inside 3.5 minutes now. And Scurll going back out to the outside. They need to be focused on closing out the match here. Marty, torpedo DDT through the ring post. I think Scurll took that move a few minutes ago, a little personal though. Marty's now, the seems trying to hurt Kenny Omega. Omega fighting him off as we are just about inside 3 minutes here, and Marty Scurll is busted open off that enziguri. We have less than 3 minutes to go in this contest. Caught the leg into a V-trigger in Kenny Omega. Scurll counters with a forearm. Winkler back elbow misses. Omega gonna send Scurll back into the ring. Marty on the defensive right now. Deadlift German off the canvas into the bridge. One, two, high angle bridge from Omega. Only a two count. 2.5 minutes left. Scurll almost put him away. Omega almost put Scurll away, rather right hook from Omega. Kenny Omega with the Hadouken to Marty Scurll. Omega might just want to go in for a cover off that there, just barely over 2 minutes left. And Scurll, super kick, just Kenny Omega caught the leg. Kenny Omega in control, Marty sneaks out. Marty picked the wrist and dropped Kenny Omega with a Russian leg sweep right on the turnbuckle. Omega has got to be loopy right now. Just inside 2 minutes left to go. Scurll's calling up Omega. He locks it in. Omega's in trouble. Chicken wing. Chicken wing locked in. Marty back to the chicken wing here on Kenny Omega. Omega and Omega taps. And we're clocking out in 1:39 left. Marty Scurll is moving on to Showdown in San Francisco alongside Eli Drake to challenge Hammerstone for the Northern Television Championship. To start the match, Eli Drake gets a weapon of his choosing. Holy crap, that was freaking nuts. Beat the clock, man. So you gotta hear Scurll. Eli Drake is challenging Hammerstone.